an emergency broadcast signal from Vault 88. Authentication code word, Impish. Vault 88 emergency classification. Unspecified integrity breach warning. Any available Vault-Tec personnel are required to respond under emergency protocol VT-76. This signal will repeat.
All right, what's up everybody? Welcome to my release day live stream for the Vault-Tec DLC workshop for Fallout 4. Yeah, I don't know why I said it like that, my apologies. Yeah, the Vault-Tec workshop DLC launch stream is what I actually meant to say. Anyway, I'm in a good mood, today's my birthday, so happy birthday to me and to anybody else who shares the same birthday, so that's cool, yeah? Woo, it's just another day, but yeah. Nice little birthday present to have this drop on my birthday, so I'm kind of psyched. And, yeah, I'm planning on streaming for pretty much most of the night, so for anybody who actually joins the live stream, I appreciate it. As soon as I actually start seeing people pop in and tuning into the actual stream, I will, start addressing comments and stuff like that. But yeah, right now I'm at, Murkwater construction site, and I am about to start making my way to Vault, what is it, 88? Yeah, Vault 88. So, really excited for this. Really excited for this DLC. Gonna have to help defend this checkpoint first, I'm sure. Oh, okay, never mind. Second, I want to see the comment that was just posted. The only reason why I have my comments turned off is because I like the game in actual full screen. And right now I'm not able to actually use the second screen to look at comments and stuff like that because my computer's in the other room. So my apologies if I didn't see that right off at the top. Mr. Fang Goldwing, yes. Yes, the Vault-Tec DLC, I live in the United States on the East Coast, so it was 7 p.m. Eastern Standard Time for it to release here, but it's a global release, so, and when I went to the PlayStation Store, I don't know if you're going through Steam or whatever, but on the PlayStation Store, it actually was under, I went to the actual add-on section, and I actually don't remember. It was on where it should have been showing up to purchase it. It wasn't there. So there was another tab that I went into and it was there available for purchase. So, yeah. But yeah, it's available. It's out. So, Oh, on Steam, like I said, it's a global launch for the DLC,
So much
so
care from good neighbor.
it
That
should
place is nothing but
be
trouble.
available for Steam as well. Like I said, it was 7 p.m. Eastern time here where I live. I don't really know what that converts to for other time zones, but it was a global release, so just dig around a little bit because it is there. Like I said, at the PlayStation Store, it was actually hidden. So, yeah. Like I said, I'm looking forward to it. Especially with today being my birthday, and this was, like I said, nice little present. So I am currently, just so you know, I'll show you the map. So right now, this is where the Vault 88 location actually is. It's right near the Suffolk County Charter School, and it's right near the Murkwater Construction Site settlement. So, oh, thank you. Thank you for the birthday comment. That's cool. When you get to be, in all honesty, when you get to be my age, and I probably don't sound it because a lot of people don't think that I'm my age when I talk. I actually turned 42 today. So, yeah, when you get to be starting to get closer to that 50-year-old milestone, things start to kind of take on a little bit more of a different perspective, which isn't a bad thing because I don't look my age, I don't feel my age, and I don't act my age, but it's crazy. I'm telling you right now, man, it's crazy getting older. Yeah, sorry if you keep hearing me sniffling. My allergies are kind of acting weird today. Oh, okay. So here we go. Here we go. So this is apparently where we've got to fight our way into Vault 88. So I'm going to switch to my sniper. Let's see what we got. Got one up there. Okay, so it's Raiders. Okay, we got one below. Okay, so we got three altogether so far. What about up there? So there's one down there. I'll get a little bit closer. And I'm playing on a high difficulty too, guys, just so you know. My character is just pretty ridiculously powerful because of my perks and my level. So this is gonna, the combat sequences are gonna probably be like most of the kills are gonna be one shots. But that's just because of I've got 50 days, 50, 50 days put into this game so far, so yeah, it's been quite the addiction. Plus this Overseer's Guardian is just insane as far as sniping rifles go. I mean, it's just like this is like kind of become like my go-to weapon. Like I even use it in like CQC situations. Like this weapon is just ridiculously overpowered. I'm actually surprised that Bethesda never did anything to tone the weapon down a little bit, but I'm not gonna complain. Yeah, see, he's too far off, so I will manually take him out. And again, I don't rush when I play games, especially open world games. So hope that doesn't bother you guys. I like to take my time and just really immerse myself into the game. Hence why I have 50 days of my life lost to this damn game. But I love it. It's broken, you know, it's got certain aspects to the game that obviously every Bethesda game has. But for the most part, this game has just been... This has been the only game that I basically have played since it launched. So, shoulder shot. Like I said, it's the sniper rifle that I'm using. This Overseer's Guardian is just... It's ridiculous. It's ridiculous. When I'm not using this, I go to my silenced pistol, and that thing is just, again, like, my main combination for my weapons are usually my Overseer. In the UK, it's a global release, so it should be available for you guys right now. Like I said, I live on the East Coast in the US, so it was 7 p.m. here. And they confirmed it earlier today that it was a global release. So you guys have it. You guys have it. Like I said, even on PlayStation Store, they had it tucked away. Like it wasn't even like advertised. There was no thumbnail that showed it on any of the menus. I had to actually dig to look for it. So you're probably gonna have to do the same thing. All right. Let's see. I don't see any more Vaders. Oh, okay. So let's see. Headshot. 14, 10. I'll manually take him out. So when I went into the PlayStation Store, my initial thing that I did was I went to the add-on section, you know, because obviously, you know, where it breaks it down to like currency and then actual like maps and levels that, you know, those individual sections. So I went into the actual maps and levels section and the DLC wasn't there. So I went to the main column on the left and I scrolled down to, I want to say it was either what's new or the actual add-ons from the left-hand list that you have on the PlayStation Store. And I went through and I found it through there. So, like I said, there was no thumbnails. There was, like, no promotional banners or nothing for it. So, I don't think a lot of people knew that it was releasing today or the time that it actually was releasing. So, you know, if you got any friends who are anticipating for this to come out, you might want to message them and let them know that, like, they Bethesda themselves confirmed that it's a global release, so it's out there, like it's there, across all platforms. So just got to do a little digging, I guess. You guys excited for this? Like, you know, just out of curiosity, like, you know, we only have one more actual paid DLC, which is the Nuka World, at the end of August. But, like, you know, there's been a lot of backlash with the workshop DLCs and stuff like that. But for you guys, were you anticipating? Were you looking forward to this Vault Tech? Thanks for the sub, man. And, you know, speaking for my channel, look, I'm going to be point blank with you guys. I'm new to this whole YouTubing thing, as far as content creating. You know, I do every single of the actual settlements in Fallout 4 I have completely rebuilt, and I'm just finishing up the actual final versions of all of them. So I've been editing all those videos together and getting ready to post them up on my channel, but the Fallout dedicated content on my channel, the channel name is Fallout 4 The Wasteland Outpost, but I'm going to be changing that to incorporate No Man's Sky when it releases on August 9th, because that game is probably the reason why I bought my PS4. So I'm really, really, really excited for that game. I hope the hype lives up to, you know, the expectation level, or vice versa. I hope the expectation level lives up to the hype. Because I want to do a lot of content for No Man's Sky, you know, tutorial videos, just everything. And I want to start growing my channel from just a Fallout 4 designated channel to one that actually has different games. And now that I've kind of started to understand how the actual YouTube content creation works and stuff like that, and what people are into, you know, I kind of understand a lot more of like what types of stuff to post. And like I said, you know, like I do this for fun, you know, if my channel gets bigger and people, you know, request more content, then cool. But I do this for fun. You know, I'm a creative director working on my own video game project anyway. So this is all kind of like part of the learning experience for what I'm doing with my own stuff. So, you know, getting into communities and all that kind of stuff. So let me shut up for a minute and actually start playing the game. I apologize. I tend to go off on tangents every once in a while. So, all right. So I don't see any more raiders out here. Now, oh, I heard one. It's up top. Can't wait to start building vault. I can't wait to start building the vault. And not just building the vault that's underground. I can't wait to start actually using the actual vault components and actually start incorporating that into the actual above ground settlements. Like, that is just... Because a lot of people were under the speculation that the actual vault-related items for building and stuff like that was only going to be limited to the actual Vault 88. When Bethesda came out and said that you're going to be able to take this stuff above ground, I was like, yo, what? Are you serious? Because that's basically what that's going to do now is I'm going to basically have to create, like, extra save files and scrap, like, a good portion of the actual settlements and redo a lot of them using the Vault Tech stuff. So I can't wait. Can't wait. I cannot wait. So this is like I want to explore. I'm so anxious to get underground and start this quest. At the same time, I'm trying not to bore you by me just walking around and looking at shit. There's a lot of radiation barrels around here. Holy. Well, I thank you. I appreciate that, Sir Kai. To be honest with you, like I'm not like one of these normal like YouTube like negative type people, man. Like I've grown up playing video games since the age of 4. I love every type of video game. Like I don't have like this PC master race type mentality. Like whatever you're into as far as a game, I don't judge people by that shit. Like what you are into is what you're into. Like, that's, to me, like, the beautiful thing about games, which is why I chose to become a creative director and work on my own project with a studio, is because there's something for everybody. Whether you want to play on a console, whether you want to play on a PC, a handheld device, a mobile phone, like, there's all types of things that you can get, you know, in relation to a game. And it's not about Xbox is better, or PS4 is better, or this is better. What it's about, in my honest opinion, is the fact that we are all part of a community. Like, we are all part of the gaming community, regardless of what you play on. And I just wish more people on YouTube and stuff like that would start bringing that type of mentality, you know, out into, like, their videos and stuff like that. Because, you know, like, there's just too much good stuff out here. you know, to be nitpicky and complaining about everything. Like, I don't personally see what that is about. Like, just enjoy what you've got. Like, be grateful that we've got the kinds of games that we have nowadays. Like, looking back on growing up on, like, the Atari, that's, like, and looking at where we are now, like, that blows my mind. That blows my mind to see how far gaming has come. And it's incredible. It's just incredible. It's the best medium that exists. You know, it's the best medium that exists. You know, movies are great. Reading novels is fantastic. Obviously, music is incredible, but gaming just incorporates all of that. Like it's just got it's got its hands in every single other medium, which is ridiculous. And here's a, I don't know if any of you guys have heard the news, but there was a, it's called Fallout Revelations. It was pitched at San Diego Comic-Con, and it's a live-action Fallout-based, I guess they're pitching it to get picked up as an actual TV show. There's actually a trailer that you can look at on YouTube. I believe it's up on YouTube now. I saw it on my Facebook posting. But it's an actual live-action Fallout-based, like, TV show that these individuals created and are trying to get picked up by, like, Netflix or HBO or Showtime or somebody else. And, like, the trailer was kind of boring. Like, I'm not going to lie. Like, it was kind of like, huh? Like, there wasn't any action. It was pretty much just all narrative. And like, trying to show you who the characters are and what's going on. But it has promise. And if, like, just as an example, like, if Netflix was to pick it up and they could develop it and use money to actually produce it the right way, it could be pretty badass. Like I said, it didn't blow me away. I wasn't like, oh my god, oh, but it was cool. So Fallout is huge, you know. Fallout is huge, which is why I've devoted my channel to my settlement, is because this game has just not gotten old. I've been playing this game since day one. Like I said before, now it's like 51 days. 51 days of my life since release of this damn game has been spent on this. Like, in all the years I played games, I have never had, maybe Skyrim, but I've never had a game that's consumed me that much. And to be, what is it, eight or nine months after release, the game has not gotten old. Like, that's crazy. That is crazy. So, and again, I apologize. Like I said, I take my time when I play games. I like to explore. I like to collect shit. I don't, you know, I paid for something. Like, why rush? Yeah, my stealth stat is ridiculously high. I'm basically invisible without having to use any armor that has invisibility on it. Peekaboo. I see you. Nighty night. Like I said, my go-to combo is my silenced revolver and my Overseer's Guardian Sniper. Like, those are, it's just because I play a very stealth type character. I've never been in any Fallout game, even in Skyrim. I've always been stealth. I like to snipe. I like to stay in the shadows. I like to take my time. I like luring the enemies out into like advantage, like advantageous, like kill spots. Like I love stealth. I love stealth. And I like how they did this. Like, I like how you actually like have to fight your way in to the actual vault itself. Like, it's not just like, oh, here's the waypoint, go inside, yay. Like, you actually have to like fight your way through. That's pretty cool. Excuse me. So I have a excuse me. I have a bunch of stuff that I collected a couple days ago that I never ended up going back to my settlement and dropping off. So I'm gonna drop all this onto dog meat just in case I come across any cool gear. Really? That's all he can carry? Okay. A pack of cigarettes, I'll take that. I don't need that. Alright. I'm not gonna lie, this is kind of a, kind of a... Oh, shit, huh? Just making sure he's not gonna get up, that's all. Psst. Come on, dog, get out of my way. Hey, buddy. shit. That was so suck.
Sweet.
This just leads back outside. Okay, I've already been here. Okay. Everything's clear. Okay. Apparently that was the entry loading screen.
Cease at once.
Okay.
The vault doors were meant to withstand a direct nuclear strike. Your attempts to breach this facility are laughable. Leave at once, or there will be consequences. When will you tire of this futility?
Come on up. I got some for your ass, motherfucker. Come on up, bitch. Come on.
Whoever you are, stop.
Oh, I know you're here.
Yep, I'm here. Yep, I'm up here. Come get me, bitch. See ya. Dog meat, please get the fuck away from me. Why are you always up my ass?
Vault-Tec will not forgive this vandalism. It's been hard to maintain the faith. So many years stranded here. But you can assure Dr. Braun, if he's even still around, that I have used the time productively. The great work is ready to begin.
So this bitch already sounds like a fucking nut job. Dogman, come on, man, really? All right.
You got ghouls to deal with too, huh?
I like it. I like it. Good shit. So sick. So sick how you're gonna be able to build this shit. That is so fucking badass. I'm curious if there's collectibles with this DLC. Like magazines. I'm curious. Probably not, because it's just a workshop. Shit, huh? Pip-Boy crates. That's sick. It looks just like the collector's edition. That's badass. I saw you. That's badass.
Terminal's got this locked.
Okay.
Okay, those are all sealed. Caps, I'm gonna hack that terminal. Let's take all this stuff first. Let's see. Okay, I love all the new stuff. Preserved, untarnished, hell yeah. October 23rd, 2077. Finally got a real security system. The entrance is window dressing. But if Barstow keeps bringing the top brass around, it's my ass if something goes wrong. The construction crew keeps griping about the new security measures. They can complain all they like. Is coming tomorrow. Another dog and pony show. Entrance is finally properly done, so if he brings VIPs, as long as they stick to that section, it'll feel like a real vault. Turns out the construction boys aren't so bad. Been having a friendly poker game. From the way things are going, they're going to be here a good long while yet. Got invited to some Halloween party. God knows we could use a little excitement around here. October 23rd, automated security lockdown, nuclear detonation event detected, automated vault tech emergency lockdown procedure initiated. Very sweet. I like that. You know, it's nothing, it's, the logs weren't anything deep in like, wow, like, oh my god, it's so, oh shit, this huge amount of lore. It said what it needed to say, and it told you what happened to this vault, and a little bit of a, you know, back history as to what took place. I like that, you know? Simple, to the point, cool. Let me open the vault and move on. That's cool.
Good. Very good. Vault Tech workshops require their control board to function. During emergencies, the procedure is to store it in the reactor room. Look in there, you should find it.
Okay.
Reactor room, huh?
Okay, that's debris that I'm going to be able to take apart later.
Step control board. Sweet. Cavaliers that are on. Got about 12 of those. Radio beacon. That's cool. That's either going to either draw enemies to this location, or draw settlers, or both. So that's cool. Alright, so now I got to install this. Okay. I don't think things for Vault-Tec Workshop open up right away. Alright, let's just look. What we got? Okay, so it does. Okay. Oh, wow. Domestic utility. Oh, shit, look at all this stuff. Hell yeah. What? Oh, this is nuts. Nice, man. Nice. Look at all this stuff to build with. That's so fucking badass. Rooms. Common, cafeteria, clinic. Oh, wow. There's tons of shit. Holy. Atrium. What? Wow. Holy shit. There's a lot of building items. What? Holy. All kinds of doors. Wow, that's so fucking sweet. Wow. Well, judging from just the items that they're giving us to build with in this Vault-Tec Workshop, man, I'll tell you what, in my personal opinion, compared to the other Vault, the other Vault workshops, the other workshop DLCs, wow, that's pretty sick. Furniture. Beds. Let's just see what some of these are. Nice. New beds. Sick of looking at all that weathered, torn up, crappy looking shit. Okay, here we go. Nice. Dining tables, a bench for booths to eat and sit. That's cool. Brand new chairs. Look at that shit. Brand new motherfucking chairs. All different kinds of colors. Hell yeah. Oh man, that's what I've been waiting for, man. Some new stuff. New items. New decorations. Like, hell yeah. I mean, obviously, it's going to be new stuff because it's, the underground vault, but there's a bunch of it, which is cool. Like, I wasn't expecting that. Like, I was expecting, maybe a couple shit. Like, there's an abundance of new shit. Like, that's fantastic. Oh, nice, man. See, like, even Vault-Tec themed, items, containers and stuff like that, man. Like,
And they give you like a weathered version and they give you a brand new version. Like, that's so sick. Overseer's desk, or just a desk in general. That's so sick. New. Look at that, man. New dresser. New dressers. No more with the ones with the fucking drawers hanging out and all broken up and shit. Like, oh man, that's so sick. Clothing hampers. File. Oh, what? Yes. Yes, Bethesda. Thank you. Thank you, thank you. Thank you, thank you for this. Alright. Very good. Some nice new metal shelves. Oh, very cool. Look at these. Haha, it's badass. Tables. Oh, fuck yeah. That's excellent. This is excellent. Excellent, excellent. Counters. What? Wow. So, like, see, the cool thing about this is, like you can actually, like, and this is going to, you know, a lot of these things are so awesome to be able to now implement into the settlements that I've already built and, like, actually go into and be able to, like, further build them and make them look new. Because, like, that's one of the things that I've done with all my settlements is I've tried my best with what we've been given up to this point to actually make my settlements, you know, look like they're being brought back to like relatively new aesthetic standards. And like, you know, up to this point, the couches and all the furniture and the, you know, has just been like, it's all weathered, which obviously, you know, it fits the actual tone of the game. And I get that, but like now it's going to let us actually like new tables. Like that's so fantastic. Oh my God, I'm so happy already. Like, just with the aesthetic decorations and building stuff, I'm already liking this DLC more than any of the other ones. Not Far Harbor. Like, I'm talking about the workshop DLCs. This is great. Fish rags, that's from Far Harbor. Carts. That's sick. Oh, we get sinks and yo, what? Thank you, fucking Bethesda. That is so, so appreciated. Oh my God. Look at all these cool new things that we can decorate with, man. What? Are you serious? Brand new counter. New ottoman. Projectors. New TVs. Oh, hell yeah. Hell yeah, hell yeah, hell yeah. Yep, that is sick. That is sick. Display cases. Floor coverings. So there's new floor coverings too. That's cool. Let's see what we got. Okay. Wall decorations. No flags. Obviously, mounted creatures wouldn't be. We got paintings. No new paintings. Let's see if we got any posters. Sorry if I'm scrolling so fast. It's just I basically have the layout of this shit memorized because of how much I've played this. So yeah, I don't think there's any new posters. At least not the electric ones. Signs. Let's see what we got. Okay, here we go. So what do we got? Oh, very cool. Very, very cool. Nice, nice, nice. Good shit. Good shit. Oh, brand new Edotronic. Okay. Oh, shit. Oh, nice. I mean, I seen this in the Bethesda Twitch stream, but, like, yeah, that's... Fuck yeah, man. Oh, okay, so there's the actual theme vault posters. Okay. Nice. Vault signs. Okay, so these are for marking areas and stuff like that. Very cool, very cool. Miscellaneous. What do we got? This is computers. Oh, that's so awesome. Because I have a few things in some of my settlements where I actually made them into, like, things that needed, like, legit terminals and computers and stuff. So that's going to be really cool to add into them. Very, very nice. And these little crates and all this. Oh, man, this is fantastic, man. Like, hell yeah. Very, very, what? Get the fuck out. Really? Christmas trees? Are you serious? That is so sick. No statues. Okay, what do we got for miscellaneous? Let's see. I'd like some new soda vending machines. That would be sweet. That would be sweet. Not a necessity. Okay, brand new jukebox. That's cool. but that would have been cool. Just saying. It's not, okay, here we go. So what do we got? We got the brand new ashtray, we got brand new radio, speaker. What? Nice, dude, nice. What? Very good. Thoroughly impressed so far. Alright, so enough of that. Let's move on to the next part. So I need to go back over here. Let me save this. Hope everybody's having a good day. Whoever's watching the current live stream or whoever ends up watching this video at a later date, I appreciate you very much tuning in. It's awesome. Yeah, we gotta get on here. I think I'm going in circles. Yep, I went the wrong way. Sorry about that. Alright, let's see. Here's the hallway. Here we go. Okay, so gotta go into building mode and take this out of the way. Mining helmet. Blowtorch.
You aren't what I was expecting. You do have a Pip-Boy. You're from a vault. But you're clearly not with Vault-Tec. What are you doing here? Why did you help me?
It was the neighborly thing to do.
Such a fine sense of civic duty. Very laudable. My name is Valerie Barstow. And I was to be the overseer of this vault. But please, follow me. I have a proposal for you. It's been a hard 200 years. I was giving a tour of what was to be my pride and joy. My vault. Then, the earthquakes. Sirens. Many died. Perhaps they were lucky. The radiation. Somehow.
The construction crew didn't fare as well as me. They've never done anything hostile towards me, though. It's probably best if you put them out of their misery.
Okay.
It's better to put the poor fellows out of their misery at last. Digging my way to the entrance. With that control board, I could have changed everything. But there was simply too much rubble for the equipment to handle. But my work kept me going. Here, among these papers, is my life's work. I'd like to share it with you. Dr. Braun tasked me with something vital. A series of prototypes and their related... experiments that could redefine society. But, as you can see, things did not go according to plan.
What are these experiments?
Ingenious devices that will improve the efficiency and health of a community. They are admittedly prototypes, and may have a design flaw or two. But nothing that can't be fixed with some elbow grease.
You mentioned Dr. Braun. Who is he?
Dr. Braun is the head of the Societal Preservation Plan. A brilliant scientist and administrator. And, no doubt, dead. A tremendous loss.
Sounds like you've had a pretty tough time.
I've had many dark days down here. Even despair. But the work. Always the work sustained me. This vault was meant to be spacious, full of trained staff, trusted subordinates and scientists. Despite how things have played out, I see opportunity. Let us work together, as partners.
What's my role?
I recognize that you are in a superior bargaining position. I'll handle the mundane nuts and bolts of vault management. Anything you want, I'm happy to accommodate. All I ask is you run the prototype experiments.
Let's do this then.
Good. Excellent. We cannot begin
Until I have my overseer's desk to run the experiments, the information in the desk's terminal will prove vital. I entrust you with the future of our vault. Vault 88.
There we go. Hey. Yes. This won't work without power.